artist colony advertise their shows and their activities through posters and through pamphlets that they put it right on the wall. One of the things that caught my attention is a painting that is done right on the wall here on West Broadway on the corner of Broome Street that says, "I am the best artist." Can you tell us when you decided to become the best artist?
Well, it started about 3 years ago when I, after being living in Soho and going around through all the different galleries and seeing what other people are producing, I came upon the conclusion that I was. So it's about 3 years ago, since 79.
Now, before 79, you were not the best artist?
No, I had no ways of proving that. I if I made that statement and somebody would call my bluff, I couldn't prove it, you know.
So now you are proving that you are a legitimate best artist.
Right, I can prove it. I can stand behind that statement.
Now, do you find critics more receptive to your work than now you are the best artist?
No, that's actually the why I say that I'm the best artist, because the critics will not touch me with a 10-foot pole. They are afraid of what I might do to the world of art.
Do you know any other best artists besides yourself or other people that you can consider also, or you are the best of the best?
No, the main person that I actually admire a lot and have studied continuously is Leonardo da Vinci, because I seem to be, you know, this sounds pretentious, I know, but it looks as though I have some sort of a parallel line with the same way that he was, and I am as eclectic in creating as he is. And that's one of the reasons why it made me say that I think he was the greatest of them all. You know? You see that we live in a world of a specialization, and everybody has to just create in certain things, because that's the only way that you can actually push that product. If you do too many different things, the critics and the museums and the art galleries think that you have not found your ways, that you are experimenting, that so they cannot conceive today, like for instance Leonardo. Today, he couldn't sell the Mona Lisa because there are not a million Mona Lisas. There is only one, and he never painted, you know, he was not a painter, he was not a an engineer, he was not a doctor, but he was into all these things because he was...
Well, he was a Renaissance man.
Yeah, right, exactly, and I found myself in that same situation. I cannot make a Campbell's soup and then get, as you know, millions of them and put them out. That you do with Toyotas and with other...
How you support yourself?
My wife supports me.
Oh, I see. So even though you are the best artist, you're not able to sell your work?
Of course not. That's why I did this over here, because I call the critics and I call everybody and they don't consider what I do art. See, I am an artist and I am creating this, but I have to wait until their god, you know, comes over here and says with the magic wand, "You are now the next such and such."
Yeah, but this, how can people buy this this painting? You know, probably they will have to buy the whole building before they can, you know, really purchase your work.
No, because the thing is that I am actually looking for a grant or something like that to keep on producing. My work is at my gallery, and this is just a sample of what I can do.
Oh, I see. So you have a gallery in addition to this outside work?
Yes, I have a place where I show.
So, okay, let's go then to this Best Artist Gallery. Can you suggest something to young people, what they should do to become the best artist so they can follow your advice?
Well, they have to now get into the academy more. I'm trying to bring the academy more into art, you know, like the Dadas and the Bauhaus and all these people took the academy out of it to a point where now anybody can just call themselves an artist. But if a person really wants to be a good artist, it should start by drawing. Not everything is art. The most people believe that everything is art. I don't. I think that what makes it art is the person who is dedicated to creating.
What do you mean most people believe that everything is art?
Well, this is a common belief. They say that, you know, they started that, like Duchamp started saying that every found object, everything in the world is art.
Well, some artists believe that everything is art.
But I don't. I believe that nothing is art. And the person had their inner vision transformed it into art. I had to create the promotional artwork is calling myself the best artist because I cannot wait.
In other words, your art is the sign that reads, "I am the best artist."
Well, no, this is just an aspect of it. See, I can create thousands of works inside there, but if nobody knows that I am doing it, is useless. It's just.
In other words, what you want is when people see the San Amebets artists, they will be curious enough to come and really see the real artwork. Okay, viewers, so the thing is, if you want to see the work of the best artists, you can come to 147 Wooster Street and judge for yourself. You can go inside and see the actual work of the best artists.